What's up, everybody, and welcome to 5 Easy Breakdance on B-Boy Moves Everybody Can Learn From At Home Part 2. After I got such a positive feedback from the first video, I decided to give you a continuation and show you 5 other moves. And if you haven't watched Part 1 yet, click on the link above, where I show you moves like Baby Freeze, Backspin, Kick Up, and so on. And before you continue with the video, don't forget to subscribe for workouts, tutorials, and knowledge. Every like, comment, and subscription is appreciated. Thank you very much for your support. Before I start, I would like to say that I do everything clockwise. But if it's more comfortable for you to do everything the other way around or counterclockwise, then feel free to do that. And by the way, you do not need to wear a hat, and I'm just wearing it because it's pretty cold here. Alright, the first move I would like to show you is the shoulder freeze. The shoulder freeze is pretty much related to the baby freeze, and it's actually very easy. Alright, in order to learn the shoulder freeze, you need to position yourself, first of all, like this. The next step is, you put your right or your left shoulder on the ground so that it stands in a 45 degree angle to the other arm. Just like that. The next step would be to elevate your legs and your hips and walk slowly towards the right arm here. But keep in mind not to move the arms both left and right at all. And this step here is actually the most difficult one. Here you need to jump up and land with the right knee or with the right leg on the left arm, just like that. And that's actually it. You first of all train to jump up and maybe even keep this position here. And then you put your right leg to the left arm, just like that. There's also another way to learn the shoulder freeze. You start in this position, then you roll slowly backwards, stretch your right or left arm, take the momentum, put the arm here down, and land in the shoulder freeze position. When you're in this position, you can close your legs, you can elevate them even from the elbow, you can, I don't know, twist them, and you can even do many transitions with that. For example, you can go into the baby freeze, you can go into this freeze here, you can even go to the chair freeze, which will be my third one. Alright guys, the second move is the three step. Maybe some of you guys heard already about the six step, which is more or less the basic footwork move in breakdance. I personally think that the six step is a bit more difficult to master and learn than the three step. When you do the three step, it's very important to know the coordinations and know where to start and where you will end. That means, if we start in this position and I'm looking into the camera, my end position will be the other way around. So, step by step. We start in this push-up position with the legs and with the arms a bit open. Then we push with the right leg to the left side while the left leg bends. One. That would be the first one. On the other side, it would look like this. So this is one movement. It's not one, two, like you have it in a six step, but it's both moves at the same time. It's very important. Keep that in mind. The second move would be, you just twist your legs. You just change them just like that. Very easy. And while you change, your arm also changes. Just like that. All right? One, two. Pretty easy. The third step is actually also pretty easy. You take your right arm, if you're clockwise, of course, position this arm on the other side here, and then you open your legs just like that. All right, one, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, and three. Actually pretty easy, and if you do that fast, it will also look pretty nice. Whew. Alright guys, it got pretty warm, the head is off, and the third move I would like to show you is the turtle face. From all of the five moves I show you today, this one is I think the easiest. It actually starts from one position and the only thing you do after that is balancing yourself. But let me show you how that functions. We again start in this position like we did with the shoulder freeze. The next thing we do is we put the left arm, if we go clockwise, to the front and we turn the right one to the back or to the side, but I would not advise you to do it like this because that will be very uncomfortable. So turn it to the back as much as you can. Then you just lean to the front, put your head on the ground, and then you try to elevate your legs up, just like that. The right arm should be around the middle or between the middle and the side of your stomach, somewhere here. But that all depends, of course, how you feel more comfortable or in which position you feel more comfortable. Some friends of mine love to do it very much in the middle. I, for example, can't. I'm not flexible enough for that. So I do it more or less here in the middle. I do not advise to do it too much to the side as you will kind of slip away and you might hurt yourself. Quick summary, left arm to the front, the right one to the back, in the middle of the stomach, we go on the head, elevate the legs and do whatever we want with them. Pretty easy actually. If you want to learn power moves, this move is a must. So make sure to do this properly. And number four, the chair freeze. The fourth move is definitely the most difficult from all of the five moves today as it requires a bit flexibility. And because it requires a bit more flexibility, girls usually have it easier with this move than guys. We start with the left hand to the front and with the right one again into the stomach. But now this is the tricky point, we need to put our right arm here as close to the side as we can to hold kind of this position. We start in this turtle freeze position, we put the head on the ground, look still to the left side, not like that, just like that. Then we twist our hips. This is the crucial part of the chair. We need to twist our hips so that we land and end up in this position here. From here, we need to put the right leg onto the left one, and you then need just to hold this position. You can combine the chair freeze also very good with the baby freeze, shoulder freeze, etc. While all of them are of course kind of connected. So if you would start here in the chair freeze, you would go into the baby freeze, into the shoulder freeze, into the turtle freeze, and then again into the chair freeze, for example. The fifth and last move for today is the coin drop. The coin drop is also a requirement for power moves like munchmill or windmill, of course. You first of all need to understand the principle of the coin drop and how it functions. We start in this position here, go on the right elbow, then we go with the arm down to land on the shoulder, but not on this side, but more or less on the back side, right? So that you're not just push against the ground like that, but that you do everything smooth. One, two, okay? It should not be bam, bam. That will just hurt your shoulder, trust me, and you will feel that. So try to go on the back of your shoulder. So one, two, and up. Do this exercise a couple of times so that you get used to the motion. If you're comfortable to do this in the push-up position, you start to do this from this position with a slight jump. That means pump, pam, and pam. Super easy. The slower you do it, the more difficult it is. I just make it on purpose very slow to show you the motions step by step. So, you jump up, elbow, shoulder, roll, and push yourself up. Just learn this rolling over the back from shoulder to shoulder and it will be no problem at all. What's very important is that you jump up from your shoulders when you do this exercise at the end, when you want to go back on your legs. That means when you push here and you push up to land in this position. And you can of course do that from standing later on as well. That means you are standing, go down and jump up. So one, two, three, jump up. Whew. The aim at the end of the day is to do this exercise without going on your elbow. That means you just directly go on your shoulders and jump up. But for now, this is definitely enough. And if you master this, you already have a very nice and beautiful move. Alright guys, thanks a lot for watching and subscribe for further tutorials, workouts and knowledge. Good luck and don't break your bones, that's not what the break and breakdance stands for. Stay healthy and see you next time.